Hey guys, welcome back to Unbiased Magic Reviews. I'm glad you're here. Today, I've got another honest and unbiased review for you. I'm going to be taking a look at Now You Sleeve Me by Jeffrey Wang and Shin Lim. So this was put out by Illusionist, and if you picked this up over this past weekend like I did, then you probably only paid $9 for this. Otherwise, you're going to be paying $15 for this 20-minute instructional download on sleeving. What you're going to learn here is you're going to learn Jeffrey Wang's sleeving method, which varies from traditional sleeving methods in that the hand is more rigid. There is not that hand motion that sometimes is associated with sleeving, which is why often sleeving is hidden by larger motions. And let me just give you a quick example of what traditional sleeving looks like so you can see it for yourself. So what we classically see is this, where a coin is put into the hand and then it's tossed back and forth a few times and then finally it's vanished like that. That's typical type of classic sleeving. Okay, so probably the first thing you're wondering about is what you're gonna get with this 20-minute downloadable instructional. And what you're gonna get is you're gonna learn three different types of sleeving vanishes. Then you're gonna learn a lot of little applications of it. And he also goes over a couple of very short, quick routines that you can use this for. So just to touch on the highlights, the different types of sleeving vanishes you're going to learn, I'm going to tell you about them in order of easiest to most difficult. The easiest one you're going to learn is called the circle vanish, and that's the one that you saw at the end of the trailer where you put the coin in the middle of the hand and do a circular motion over the hand. And that one you're going to learn very quickly, and it's very easy, and I think part of the reason is because the hands are very close together. The second easiest vanish is the JT vanish, or the Jeffrey toss vanish. And in that one, you're taking the coin and you're basically just tossing it into your hand and it vanishes. And again, there's not a lot of hand motion, which is good. But the only thing about that you have to be careful is with your angles, because it's really easy to flash. So you really can't have anybody on your side or behind you. They have to literally be right in front of you, and you have to be angled, you have to be turned, because if you're not, they'll see something, something will flash. The Jeffrey toss vanish, which the hand does remain very rigid, and it just looks like you're going from here to here, and it's also just vanishing. So I'd say that's the second easiest technique on there. So. And then the most difficult version he goes over is what he's called the JC vanish, or the Jeffrey clap vanish. And that's where he's just taking the coin in his hand head on, and he's basically just doing this and it vanishes. And I tell you guys that that's the most difficult one, probably because it does use inertia. And in that one particularly, it does matter what kind of clothing you're wearing. Some clothes is going to be a lot easier than other clothing. Some jackets or coats are going to be a lot easier than other ones as well. So It would have been better if he had gone over that in the video, and he really didn't. But you'll learn by experimenting, as I have, that some things just work better than others. The applications you're going to learn on this video is you're going to learn all kinds of applications of how to vanish one coin or how to make one coin turn into another coin. He goes over how to take a coin and make it look like you throw it on a string, like if you're doing a charming Chinese challenge. He also goes over a couple of routines on there. One of the routines is called finger through coin, where you throw a coin in the air and it lands on your finger but penetrated, and then you take it off your finger and it's got a big hole in it, and then from there you just do the Jeffrey clap, vanish, and amazingly now you've got a restored coin again. And for that routine you do need to have the karate coin gimmick naturally to be able to do that, and he shows you how you could use his sleeving techniques to switch those coins around. He does have another routine called multiple changes, where you're changing a silver coin into a copper coin, and then the copper coin into a Chinese coin, and then finally vanishing the Chinese coin. I thought that routine was pretty good. The one thing that I would say is maybe it would have been better if he had shot it from other angles, if he had done more slow motion, if he had explained it a little better, because he did go through the explanation really quickly. Finally, he does show you another routine, which is called the circle spellbound, where it's not just the circle vanish, but it's also changing the coin from a silver coin to a Chinese coin or to any other coin you want to. So it's a combination of different things. Some of the other applications I thought that were really good was there was something called the JC portal, where it's not just the clap vanish, but it's a vanish and reappearance. And in this one, the hands don't come together. So it looks like you're just tossing the coin here, and then the coin is just magically reappearing on this side, almost as if it's going through an imaginary portal. And I thought that looked really clever. Of course, that's going to take some practice to learn, because it's definitely not easy. Practicality, I would say that some of the applications of these sleeving techniques are not really that practical, because to do the reappearances, you have to have a coin in a certain position to be able to make it reappear, and that's not going to be something that's going to be easy to get there. It's not something that you can just walk up to somebody and be like, hey, check this out, and just do it. You're going to need a moment to set up for that, and you can't have somebody scrutinizing you while you set up for it. Probably a lot of you will find that a lot of this stuff is easier done while seated too, in terms of the vanishing and reappearing of coins. I could see how it'd be done easier while you're sitting. Overall, that's what you're going to get on there. Some questions you probably have is, how difficult is it to learn this stuff? I'm telling you right now, some of this stuff you're going to pick up really quickly, like that circle vanish, you'll learn that really quickly. Some of the other things are going to take a little more practice to learn. And I think, though, that with a little bit of practice, a couple hours, I think that you probably get most of this stuff down. The angles, like I said, on a couple of these moves are kind of iffy, and you'll figure that out on your own just by practicing it. The teaching on the video, I told you guys about it, what I thought could have been improved. I think that anybody who's into sleight of hand magic is really going to enjoy this a lot. And I think that in terms of comparing it with other methods, I think that really it does stand up pretty well. And I think for $15, you're really getting your money's worth. So I wouldn't hesitate to recommend this to you guys. I wouldn't hesitate to rate this as 4 out of 5. And the only reason I don't rate it 5 out of 5 is because I think that there is kind of a practicality issue with some of the applications. That being said, I think that a lot of this could be definitely things that you could use immediately. That little sequence you saw in the trailer where the coin gets tossed into a tic-tac box, I could see how people would use that immediately. It's too bad they actually didn't go over that in more detail, showing you exactly how to do that. I mean, it's very easy to figure out how to do that on your own. I mean, it's not gonna take any rocket science to figure out how you could make that happen, but it just would have been better if they had included that. Just my opinion on it. If you guys are into sleeving and you want more resources to learn more about sleeving, I would highly recommend that you check out the work by Witness Cow. He put out a DVD called Sleeving System, and there he teaches something he calls shoot sleeving. And I thought that his ideas of switching like one Sharpie for another with just one hand, I thought that was incredible. Johan Stahl put out a DVD called Sleeveless Sleeving, which I thought was really good. In fact, the best part of his DVD was that he put out a pretty involved routine that had to do with a pen and a coin, or a Sharpie marker and a coin, and I thought that was really good. That was on there. Alexander Dakova put out a DVD on sleeving, which I thought was good. There are some FISM winners that have also put out stuff on sleeving, including Rick Merrill. If you get any of his lectures, Penguin Lecture, At the Table Lecture, they all have sleeving on there, as well as Soul Park and Lucas. They put out a sleeving DVD set, but that was more like stage sleeving. They did like a lot of billiard ball sleeving and stuff like that. But you might enjoy that if you're into it and you're looking for more resources. I also do plan on doing a review shortly on Justin Miller's release on sleeving that was called Bulletproof Sleeving. I've actually been asked to do a review on that, so I plan to do that shortly. That's a 2.5 hour video. And that's pretty much it for this review. And if you guys have any questions about any of this stuff, please leave me a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any of my reviews. I hope that you're having a great week. And thanks again for tuning in. I'll see you guys on the next review.